Welcome. Today we are going to create a plane in Maya. So the first thing that we need to set up is our reference images. So we'll switch to the foreview by pressing space. Then we're going to go to view, image plane, import image, and select the top image. Here we're going to select the front image. And the same thing then here for the side view. So when we have now all our images imported, the first thing that we need to do is move them to the sides so we actually can see what we're going to do. Then the next thing what we need to do is align these images that they're also positioned correctly. So the one thing that you have very often when you import blueprints, since they were drawn by hand, that these images do not match up perfectly. So you need to decide which one of these images is going to be your dominant and correct image. And so to do that, we just create a cylinder because our main body is going to be based off a cylinder, because a plane is basically a cylinder with two boxes on its side. So then we rotate this 90 degrees and reduce the subdivision axis. And now we look here for a very prominent feature of the plane. So in this case, I would say it would be this line from the nose. So we clearly can see it here in this. So from the top view and from the side view. And from the front view, we also can know where it is. So in order to see things a little bit better, you can go to shading and say X-ray. Then your model is going to be rendered a little transparent, and then you actually can see the underlying blueprint. So we do the same for all the views, just to see what's going on. Okay, then let's start here with the side view, and let's move the cube over here, the cylinder over here, and make it a little smaller. So make it a little smaller, and let's just try to position it here for this one segment. Okay, so now it's basically aligned for the side view. But now if we take a look into the other views, we can see here this doesn't match up. So for the front view, we have to move the reference image a little down. And now it still doesn't match up, so we move it a little to the side. And now, maybe a little bit over here. And now the reference image matches where the cylinder is positioned. Now the same thing is true over here for the top view. We have to move our plane a little down. And actually scale a little upwards. A little more. Okay, now. See, now these two lines match up correctly. Now, since we've positioned all of our image planes, we can start creating the main cylinder. Or the main body, sorry. So the way to do this is you select the back faces of the cylinder, press shift, then you get the extrude option on the move operator, and then you start extruding, always to a point where you think that you're going to extrude something into the other direction. So here the wing starts, so we stop our extrude here, Then we move on over here. So here we're going to extrude our cockpit in the next step. Here's the end of the wing, end of the cockpit, start of the fin, start of the tail wing, and the end, and end of the plane. Okay, now the next thing that we are going to do is we're going to adjust the vertex positions. So we're going to move this a little up and scale it a little up. So the top vertex matches the drawing and the bottom drawing vertex also matches the drawing. Yeah, so it's just always a shift of vertex points that everything is aligned correctly. Okay, now our next step, we switch to the top view, and here we still have a base cylinder. So we repeat the same thing as we did on the side view, and just bring these vertex points a little together that they match the drawing. Again, here you have to decide which side you're going to use as a reference point, because this doesn't match up, the left and the right. So I'm going to use this line as my main reference. I'm not so concerned of the left side. Okay, so now we can see here, we created our main body for the plane.